Let's see what we gonna do.
Inbounds
backs it up. He attacked it with everything he had, but it still wasn't enough.
Good defense, not letting them jam it home.
Ball, the quick shot. Pulls the trigger. The offensive board is gathering for a party.
Great offensive rebound. He worked so hard to establish his position.
Ball was just sitting in the paint, and the ref's going to call him for it. Left. Passes it back to the left wing.
Oh, the big fellow with a tough rebound. No denying him on that one.
Carter throws it out. Nails the jump shot. Georgia Tech takes its first timeout of the game. Inbounds the ball. From downtown, offline, Avenger. The Tigers can push their lead to double digits.
Slam home a huge shot.
They're up 15-4.
There's no question what kind of defense they're in on. Damn it.
Avenger from 20 feet out. Walker reels it in. The Tigers with a lot of momentum.
It's still early, Vern, but they can't take any more time to get this thing going. It hasn't been pretty for them so far.
That's my boy.
It's stolen by Vern. Last shot was great job. Nothing like jumping on your opponent early. See how energized they are? Executing perfectly. Kempler leads him with the pass. McQuad catches it. High post. Skip pass. High post. And Avenger. And now the run by
a 15. I like that final four, son.
Gray inbounds the ball. Just over 7 minutes left in the half. Goes up. And in goes. And he's fired. He'll go to the line for a 3-point play.
He fought through the foul, no problem. This was your only 3-point chance.
Towson is good for a 3-point play. The Yellow Jackets will take a timeout.
Back to the action.
inbounds the ball. Richard.
Good work.
He's got two. The Tigers bring it up the court. They're on a 13-4 run. Walker hands it off. It falls short. They still have a 14-point lead. Clement shoots it. Misses the three-pointer.
When a D got lucky there, Vern, you can't expect many misses when you're that open.
The crossover. That's his first one. Mason Jr. Makes it to play. They take a 16-point lead. The Yellow Jackets will retain possession. Has it. Down low. Clement feeds it to the right side. High post, swings it to the wing. The 15-footer. Mason Jr. gets the board inside.
You can't afford to spot the other team any more points, Vern. They're in danger of letting this game be over before the second half.
Ball takes the shot. Richard pulls it down. Goes up. Snatched by Mason Jr.
Clement has missed quite a few shots in a row now, and it's unavoidable that it's going to start affecting his confidence.
That last 17-footer was missed by Page. Usually, if he gets any sort of room, he nails it.
If I'm the defense, I don't let him get another shot.
He can't come away with a three-point play. About 5.5 minutes left in the half. Georgia Tech calls time. Making a few lineup changes. Richard inbounds the ball.
It looks like they're playing minimum.
Filling dumps it off. Pentway from 30 feet out. It's right rim and doesn't fall.
That's going to get you a target to from your coach. Not a smart
shot. That was a thundering finish.
Not even to let them gain that kind of position.
Pentway, way up court. The Yellow Jackets were the last ones to touch it, and they'll turn it over.
They were just out of sync on that one. The pass went one way, and he went the other.
The Tigers have got a nice lead. Ball gets it on the stripe. they still lead by 18. Billings uses the crossover. Passes left wing.
The trail is 15.
He's 1 for 2 from downtown. About 4.5 minutes left in the half. Tosses it up. Collins went up and will go to the line for a couple. Richard has it in the paint.
No way he was coming up and he got the ball that close to the rim.
Carter passes it up court. Ball bounces it to the left side.
That's his second personal foul. Penalty situation.
Shooting. He makes the first. The fly was needed out of the floor. He didn't get much of a rest. Richard inbounds the ball. Left wing. Bullet. For a three. The right gets the rebound. Georgia Tech has been on the losing end of the rebound battle. And Tracy is near their bench with a report.
The Yellow Jackets coach just told his assistants, if we have to defend with five guys in the paint, then let's do it. But I'm getting very tired of seeing us getting killed on the boards. That sent them scrambling to the top.
Thanks, Tracy. Stand down by Richard.
Mr. Shot. You love to see someone take it that hard to the tent.
Just a flick of the eye, and there he is.
Yes, Tigers are going to shake things up a little bit with some subs. Wilson inbounds the ball. The Tigers with a comfortable lead. With the teardrop. Pulled in by Richard. That's his fifth rebound in this one. He tried to get fancy. He was looking for the highlight reel finish there. No good on that last shot by Bolin. Right around 3 minutes left in the half.
You know what kind of defense they're in, don't you, Vern? Hit him in.
By Wilson. The right hands it off. It's deflected, but it's recovered by Mason Jr. Carter. Evans Miller snatches the offensive rebound. That ball almost dropped in, though. If it had, he'd be looking at a potential 3 point.
He showed some real range there. Taking the foul and almost getting the shot off.
Second goal.
He had no credit to turn, Vern. His man was in his pocket the entire time and caused the turnover.
Kempler picks it up and slides in with a soft finger roll. But they're still behind by 60. 2:07 left in the first half. Goes up. Turns it on and gets by. Some substitutions. Good for the 3 point play. McCann inbounds the ball. Banjo dumps it off.
2 minutes.
McCann catches it inside, takes it up. Summers inbounds the ball. The Tigers have got a nice lead. In the key.
Oh, wow. I didn't think we got him.
Leads him with the pass. McFly gets the ball inside.
This guy's come home in September.
in the second half.
Well, that's the dude who came down there with him. Yeah, I remember this episode. You know what I used to hate niggas would say though? Niggas used to say, I knew when Rudy get older, she got older, she was gonna be fine. Why was you looking at her like that? You know what I'm saying? Like that back when she did episodes like that as a little girl. I understand she grown now when you were looking at the episode. But I'm like, still though, it's how you looking at, you know what I'm saying? Say that is a better choice of words, but then actually, I knew she was gonna be a beautiful young lady when she got older. She was a pretty little girl, you know what I'm saying? Now I knew she got older, so she was bad. I fuck her. Now, Brenda dug up. Now I see why your ass is in here. The fuck?
Inbounds it to start the second half. What a pass. Clement. Pollock puts it up. Nails it from the wing. It's 3 for 7 for the game. Let's check in with Tracy Wilson.
During halftime, I talked with Coach Jackson.
Thank you, Tracy. That was a much quicker shot than I might have liked. It was a pretty open look, so it's tough to fault it from the free throw line. Hit the front of the rim and bounced out. Off the mark by Clement. Dishes it to the high post. A little too aggressive right there. I like that he's not afraid to be physical, but that was too much.
Good for a three-point play. Harder passes it to him. Staying right before. Keeps it up.
Is shooting itself in the foot with all the turnovers. Tracy has something for us.
The Yellow Jackets coach is not sugarcoating the issue. He told his assistants, "We found a mental abysmal." And then added, "The only players I want on the floor right now are the ones that can take care of the ball."
Thanks, Tracy. Has it. Top of the key. Carter dishes it to the left wing.
He's your main guy.
Lethal. He is so hard to defend. The right gets the reach-in ball and it's foul number 2.
some substitutions. He should concentrate on just getting good position instead of flailing away at the ball like that.
Richard inbounds the ball. It's 1-1. The team is really ready for the ball.
That's how you do it. Let go of here. Wait for the mistake and then capitalize.
The Yellow Jackets need to find some answers here. Down low, takes it up. A beautiful pass led straight to the layup by Bowling. But they're still behind by 29. Walker with the shot. Evans North pulls it in and skips it to the top of the key. Mason Jr. dumps it off. Gray beats it far side from deep.
Collected by Evans North.
Mason Jr. keeps it alive on the offensive end.
Well, there is no time to shag it up. Good defensive motherfucker.
He's such a fantastic scorer.
Richard backs him down.
Wow, this place is like a morgue, Vern. We've got to give these fans something to cheer them up.
Whoa!
What I like is his ability to see the floor and get it to the guys where they can do something with it.
Extremely accurate. Georgia Tech is really struggling. Catches it. Left wing. Banjo passes to the top of the key. Out right. Clement puts it up. Just missed it. No three-point opportunity. He'll go to the line for two.
Shooting.
Didn't sit for long, and he's coming back into the ball game. He sinks the second. Mason Jr. passes it up for it. Goes up. Georgia Tech calls time. They've got one left. Looks like they're getting set to inbound the ball. Bowler inbounds the ball. The Yellow Jackets down big. Dishes to the elbow. Banjo tries to get it going. Too strong. How did he miss that one?
It happens. He's just got to shake it off and reload.
Walker hits the soft reverse. They're now up by 36. About 5.5 minutes left to the second half. Shoots it. Not there on the three by Banjo.
Their rebounding has been terrific, Vernon. That's the main reason they're leading in this game.
It's his second personal foul. Fourth team foul.
Shooting 2. Having big problems from beyond the arc. And I think Tracy has something for us on that.
Tracy. The Yellow Jackets coach wants to see his players move more effectively without the ball so they can get better looks at the basket. He told his guys, if you get to the open spot on the floor, I know you can hit that shot. Vern?
All right, Tracy. This guy is fun to watch, Vern. He can really fill it up. Ball has it on the perimeter. For the game. Mason Jr. crosses it up court. Goes up. Pulled in by Walker. Ball follows his miss. Swish. They're in front. 85 to 45. Bounces it to the wing. Headway. Tosses it up. The triple was off the mark by Bowen. It's one on one. Carter shoots.
Right up and was able to get a hand on the ball.
Passes it to the free throw line. Brower gets it down low.
What a great setup on that delivery. What a play.
Crosses it over.
He needs to make sure he gets a piece of the ball, too. He's going to find an athlete on the team.
Both teams are going to shake things up a little bit with some subs. Let's it go.
90.
They beat somebody by 130 or something.
This presentation of the Final Four.
It's too late for Halloween and too early for you to return to Capistrano.
Don't tell me, you must be the Hillman mascot.
Dwayne Wayne.
Very pleased to meet you. I'm Russell Huxtable, Denise's grandfather.
You're Denise's grandfather? Let me say it is a thrill to meet the man who created the man who created Denise.
So, you're the mascot. When I was in the marching band at halftime, we'd spell out Hillman, and then the mascot would come out and dot the L. Do you still do that?
Yes, sir.
And don't be surprised if he dots the M.
Son, I hope you feel lucky. Nothing would please me more than to pin back the ears of old Dominion Bear.
Don't worry, I'm going to wear the same underwear I wore when I aced my chemistry test.
What?
Good. Denise, by the way, how are your grades?
improvement?
Yeah, they're much better. She's in no danger of failing.
I'm glad to hear that. Nice meeting you all so much.
Hey, huh? The peach cobbler.
Oh, sorry. I guess I was used to carrying it around.
Well, I better go look for my lucky underwear.
And there he goes, poultry in motion.
She fired his ass off.
Your grandpa is so cute.
I know. Really, he doesn't seem to me like the kind of man who'd object to someone stealing a bear head.
Are you kidding? I know my own grandpa, but I could just hear him now, Denise. When I went to Hillman, we never went in for such foolishness.
I'm gonna steal that bear head if it's the last thing I do. About it. Well, that's easy for you to say. Back in 35, you were the one who stole it. Plus, how old are you? You know how old I am? I'm 2 years old. I'm pretty clearly. I'm pretty clearly.
Move, we don't move. Second place ain't my groove. Play to win. You